NITV News with Natalie Armand.
Good evening. While the politicians in Canberra continue to scratch their heads as they try to work out how to close the gap, community-controlled health organisations such as the Redfern Aboriginal Medical Service are bucking the trends and making a real difference to the health of their communities. And they may even have the answers, as Danny Teece-Johnson reports.
It was this statement by Mick Gooder that made sense to every Aboriginal medical service in the country, but yet seems so hard for policymakers to grasp.
Why aren't we getting the results? Why isn't government programs working? The answer is they're not engaging with Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander people. It's pretty simple stuff. We're not sending people to the moon here.
The Redfern Aboriginal Medical Service has been doing this for years. It provides a broad range of specialised health services that are designed by the community. In essence, the mob's health needs shape the type of service delivery they receive. It could be in the clinic, in the home, or on the street.
We've become a very specialised organisation, and each service is working in their own silos. And I suppose with the new way forward, I'm looking for everyone to work as a team and to support one another in what we're trying to provide, because really the underlying goal here is better health outcomes for Aboriginal people.
Director Ricky Lyons and his family have had a long association with the AMS. He says they're closing the gap because the community runs it their own way, the Redfern way.
We do that by listening to the community, basically. And I'm a patient here, I'm a director, a former employee, and we know about what services need to be delivered here. And particularly with our medical clinic, we, over the years, have talked to our patients, and they don't want to wait 4 hours, they don't want to wait as long as it takes to see the doctor. And what we want there from feedback from our community is that we want to have a long-term relationship with our doctors and patient.
Laverne Belair says the small things like reducing waiting times for patients keeps the mob coming back. That means health checks become regular and any issues can get picked up earlier.
I'd like to think that we empower our community rather than disempower. And I think it's giving them the right information to make those informed choices that we don't necessarily get. Or, we're too busy, or, we're something else, or you've got to go here, or you've got to go there.
And while the health of the community is the priority, the benefits of careers and employment to locals is also closing the gap, especially one in their wallets.
If you start off as a health worker, you can work your way up to be a clinic coordinator or medical coordinator and go and do nursing and dental health. And go on to other disciplines, basically, because when you start from here, you learn about Aboriginal culture and your heritage and where you connect, and then you learn about health and how we got here and what's been done, and then you take that knowledge and you grow.
We've got one service for one mob, and and we're restrained in how we do that, but we're certainly trying to achieve what a lot of health services are battling to do.
Danny Teece-Johnson, feeling healthy at Redfern AMS for NITV News.